hear it? Welcome to Relay.
But I'm not smart, so, you know, we'll just see how things go. They can hear me. Can they? Shiver, I hate you. Both of you, you're both the worst. All right, well, they're both being ridiculous, so it's time for the intro. Hello, jellies and bellies. What forepaunts does the frigbit dwell? For scuppered and scoopered schooners and scrumptions, for twig billion shivers benumbered by plublaglet. For fast, regurgitated blarney, the cabbages call whoo, whoo. Welcome to the relay station. Shiver.
Are you having a stroke?
No, I was doing an intro. Also,
hang on. Stop everything. Stop everything. Hi, Kemi.
Hi, Griffin. Hi, guys.
Thanks, Bri, for the subscription. 38 months in a row. Jesus.
Oh, wow. That's a lot of month.
Yeah.
As you can see, this week's Soul Citizens, there are two things wrong with the cast.
I'm not. Nope. I'm not.
That's the polite way to say it.
But we have two people who are not American. That's it. Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
All right.
Hi, everybody.
Wait. No, you
Bro,
can hear
Serena
him.
Can't hear us.
Yeah, he can.
No, he can't. He wouldn't say he can't hear us if he can't hear us. Isn't that
he
right,
said
Bryce,
joking.
Serena? You can't hear us, can you?
He said joke. See?
No, thank he you, said Cameron. JK. Those are his initials. Jeffrey Knowles.
It's really,
why are
really scary
because
I actually
on air.
I actually work with someone who's a Jason Knowles.
You know Bruce Brasilina in real life?
I know.
That's amazing.
In real life. All right. Welcome to the relay station. It's actually so
we can never get this started.
No,
properly.
We never can. Nakara, it's really unfortunate that Nakara isn't here. He's off actually hunting moose this week. He's been gone.
Wait. Nakara isn't black?
Not that I know.
No, you're on your own in that one, Shiver. Go ahead.
Who the fuck is this guy?
I had no idea where you're going with that one. Go ahead.
Oh wait, so the volume is good? Follow Stan? Awesome. Yeah, so Nakara's not here, which is unfortunate because he would be really, really handy this week deciphering the honestly mountain of stuff that came out. It's like we went for like 2 years without hearing about Squadron at all. And then this week they were like, oh, hey, guys, we're going to throw a hour and 20 minute Squadron update at you.
And then we're going to throw another 15 minute video on top of that. And then we're going to throw a whole document that's like a Bible on top of that.
Yeah. So
what happened? I was asleep.
Not much. So it's a letter from the chairman. There's some stuff about what they're doing for CitizenCon this year because CitizenCon doesn't exist. There's a 15-minute video with Chris Roberts and Brian Chambers and the name escapes me. anyway, talking about them talking about what they want. Yeah, elves. Thank you. Them talking about what they wanted to do with this video series. Elms. Yeah. And then there's an hour and 20 minutes.
Which, by the way, Nick Elms is also what you should do at Christmas.
Nick Elms?
Nick Elms.
No, you should Nick Pines.
No. You wanted to start a new trend.
Elms are no good as a Christmas tree. Nick the Pines. Leave the Elms.
Why do you pay attention to him? Just ignore him and continue on with the important stuff.
He knows I'm a massive birch.
I mean, let's...
You broke him. And that only took 6 minutes. Congratulations. I think that's an all-time record.
Are you okay?
I've figured it out. You know what? No, I've figured it out. For the last 5-ish years, my stress level and my anxiety levels have slowly risen. And I figured out that the root of the problem is sugar.
It's been longer than 5 years, mate.
I know. Okay. Was I saying something?
You were saying about the data dump.
Oh yeah. Okay. So, the 15-minute video with Chris is a good video to watch because there's Chris in it, and he's sort of talking a bit about. They talk a bit about what they're hoping to do with the new roadmap, and I kind of like what it sounds like. Sorry, it sounds like they're going to be doing. It's more of a here's what each team is working on. And they're going to tell us what each team is working on any week so that we have an idea of where progress is going from that, rather than saying the Cutlass Blue is 70% done. They're going to say...
It's 70% done?
No, but they're going to, instead of saying the Cutlass Blue is 70% done, they're going to say we've got three teams that are working on the Cutlass Blue right now, and they're working, one team's working on this and this and the, yeah.
You know what the problem is, though? Every time they do a massive data dump, they follow it with a data wipe.
Red one. Folostan, I completely agree. Don't understand why they couldn't get Chris like a setup, maybe a headset with the microphone, anything, just anything.
I mean, it's not like they have over $350 million to work with here or anything.
Well, they don't. I mean, they've spent a lot of that, but like, surely they've got a spare headset somewhere in the company that they can send them, right?
Don't call me Shirley, but yes, you're right.
Literally wish I could tear my skin off my face right now.
I am too proud of myself. Thank you.
You're welcome. God, I...
Take a deep breath. He's crying. Somebody's crying.
It's worth hitting up for. Oh, God. Why? Why? I had stuff I was gonna say, and it's just gone. Okay.
Shiver, stop in the beginning. Just start over.
This is part of Fastcart's tactics. You see, he does this here, encourages me to do it. We ruin the show, and it just becomes comedy. And then he goes on Soul Citizens, and he's wearing this tie, and he's like. So this week, there was such and such a problem, and I believe that the floating point unit is now 64-bit capable.
Ah, that's what it is. Now that Fastcart's on his own show, he's sabotaging ours.
And then Shiver comes and PM me and try to sabotage me on when I'm on Show Citizen every single week.
Oh, he does that
like,
to
whenever
me too.
Whenever you see me looking in the corner and then looking in the camera disappointed, that's Shiver.
Yep.
And Shiver knows that. Look at his reaction.
He loves it. Okay. You know what? Let's go right into the show and tell because I'm just lost. So they did a nice, like, hey, the
these are the type of moments I want to be a part like, of in Star Citizen, coming together as a group and completing a
honestly,
task
the
that feels
the
just
thing
truly epic.
Star Citizen is going. Let's not
to explore to connect.
Let's not play around at all. It's impossible, it is people that are crazy enough to have 19.
I recognize that guy.
I do too. It's
Pascal. Friends that become family.
I recognize these people.
It is amazing.
It's
quality of people.
These are the people that keep the game going. These are the people that are essentially the brand ambassadors for Star Citizen. It's the people that love the game and continue the love
VIP
of the game
is secure.
I have had much fun in Game and Out. Momenti memorabili in gioco
ce ne sono stati tantissimi. I'm just going to turn that down.
Continue on.
Sorry, I forgot that there was sound. It's the community that is that are basically the brand ambassadors for Star Citizen. CIG do not nearly as much marketing as they should at a AAA game or might need to. It's these people. It's that crazy dude right there. It's the people that have continued playing this game for the last 5 years and coming up with ways to move bennies and like just people that have figured out how to have fun with Star Citizen. And the community's great and they are what are keeping Star Citizen alive. So it's really good that they are celebrating the community during the time when honestly this is the time of the year that normally the community would get together and we can't this year and it's really unfortunate. But
may I have a moment?
Yes, of course.
So, I was actually approached to do a segment for this video here, and they said they gave me a week. Normally, when I'm on these kind of things, they come up to you, and it's like last minute, I have 5 minutes to prepare, and I'm like, go. I wanted to say so much, and so much came to mind that I could my brain kind of froze, and I couldn't get anything out in video. But I do want to say thank you to the community, and thank you for being awesome. Thank you for being supportive. I wouldn't have been able to come to CitizenCon 2018 without you. You know, it's a great community, and I love you, everyone in it.
Yeah.
So that's what I would have said if I were able to get my act together and be in the video. And I want to apologize for Tyler for not responding back to him. I just didn't know how to say what I just said. So thank you.
Words are hard sometimes. It's yeah.
And you know,
that's
I'm normally
accurate.
Go ahead.
Fastcart, that's almost accurate. You forgot to say I love this community, but especially the community's wives. Right, gray-headed gamer.
Anyway, thank you for bringing back the comedy. Thank you. No, but it's just people know me. I try to be comedic, try to be funny, try to make it light. And you know, when they approached me with this, I took it too serious, and I couldn't rectify being comedic and serious within a 5 minute period. So. Yeah, I whiff on that, so.
That's all good. It's, it happens. It's, Yeah, it's really unfortunate that we can't all get together this year like we normally do, but you know, we all have to try and stay safe. So
and I'm going to give a special shout out to Rickstrom. He's showing on the video right now on my screen anyway, for, you know, in memory of Rickstrom. That was a nice touch, right, to what they did.
Yeah. Okay, let's hop into some of what they showed this week. So, I mean, that's creepy. The masks. But
I mean, I think it's a subliminal message from CIZ to get people to wear masks in real life, to try to get people to wear masks in game.
Yeah. Are CIG selling masks yet? They should have a Star Citizen face
I was
mask.
Thinking the same thing like not 90 minutes ago. I was like,
look, they CIG, could charge,
they'll make a killing if they sell a mask.
They could charge $35 for it plus $20 shipping.
I was thinking more like $19.99, but the shipping you may be correct on.
Shiver, are you okay?
He's having a stroke.
When you said mask, I didn't realize you meant real life mask. But then when, and I was like, what? Are we playing fucking Fortnite now or some shit? And then you made it to real life mask and that price. And I'm like, thank God you don't work for their bloody. yeah. Because, you know, there's well, some I poor bastards. There's going to be a group of poor bastards lining up for a
okay. How about
stupidly this? Priced mask.
How about that? How about not $35 for one, but $35 for two? You get a Squadron 42 mask and a Star Citizen mask.
They get really dirty.
Nope, Shiver, nope.
Actually, did I? I don't know if I've got the
bot good job
online. I hope this doesn't mess anything up. I need to go check something.
Yeah. I lost it right as well. Oh. Yeah, don't forget, $40 or whatever for a fucking mask and then $20 shipping. He's right.
I mean, that's what they would charge. Let's. I remember back in the day.
I kind of get lucky with the shipping because the shipping seems to be this flat rate. And, you know, sending it to Japan costs as much as it sends to UK. So
yeah. I mean, you get lucky. Sending it to Canada shouldn't be hard, but, you know. Where are we?
Okay, about the mask. Have you guys in game yet?
Oh, why did it resize this?
Can I complain about those masks? Because I think this is fucking inane. I'm sorry to bring down the mood, but this is fucking inane. Like, the way to get these masks is kill, 50 people or something like that?
Yeah, I'm not going to be able to do that one.
You think this is a good idea, CIG, when people are already pissed off complaining about PvP when it's griefing or, you know, being dragged into PvP when I'm in a PvP. But, you know, that sort of thing. It's not a good idea. And then have you seen that there are some streamers who literally have people who are viewing them lining up to be killed just so the stream can get the mask. It's a bit. Really? Yeah. Really, CIG? Did you not see this coming? Really?
I mean, they're kind of cool, but also I don't feel like they fit in Star Citizen to begin with, to be honest. Like,
The Vanduul one does, but the others maybe not so much.
Even in my opinion. I don't know. Even the Vanduul one to me is a little like, I don't know. I don't like them, but that's me.
Well, it's a good thing CIG is not forcing anyone to get these masks. It's purely a choice of your own and everyone else's, so.
But that's not entirely true, Fastcart, because you may not be trying to get the mask, but someone else might be, and that means they're trying to hunt you down. Which is a bit shit.
It's.
I mean, don't forget, we are not meant to be playing this game at the moment. You are meant to be trying to find some of the many bugs and doing reports on them and saying, you know, here's a bug and here's how you recreate it. Not hunting down 50 players for a mask. Not always trying to look check over your shoulder to be the hunted.
If there were a especially if there were PvP servers or a buggy. PvP mode, like you could opt in to PvP, then PvP for the mask would make sense.
The comments of Eris do not reflect on no. That's going to get some comments on YouTube.
Anyway.
But I mean, I'm partial to the Vandal mask, and I guess we're going to cover this later, but also we have the helmet for the Origin ship. Okay, you know about those?
No, I didn't.
Need the link?
Possibly. Sorry, I'm just starting up the next. Okay. There's like a little trailery thing for 311, which 311 is out.
I haven't heard. How is it?
Broken?
I just want to thank CIG so much for celebrating my birthday by releasing 311, releasing the Origin 100 series. Thank you, CIG. I really appreciate it. It's a very nice birthday present from you.
It's... I don't know. Vote Addison. All right. It's sort of a CIG are in a tough spot because we know that every time they unleash a new patch, everything breaks. That's just the way it works, right? But it sort of sucks when it's like long week, or wait, hang on. It's not a long weekend in America. Sorry.
No, not well. It is. It well.
It's Thanksgiving this weekend up here in Canada. So it's like long weekend, patch release, everything borked. But, you know.
It's not, I mean, it could be worse. You could invent, or you could release this video card that you know is highly sought after, and then 2 weeks after it releases in one of your major production areas, you can have a week-long holiday where everything shuts down, even though there's demand over 300% for this card.
Happened.
Everything is built and ready, just waiting for one bloody card. Really, really annoyed. Man, even Larian can't get a 3080.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, that's neither here nor there.
I think the link's in Discord. I don't know if you can look at them.
Got it. Actually, I can... Helmet triple pack. Oh, is this 10?
And while I'm complaining... Fuck Sony, because I bought these fucking amazing headphones from Sony, right? 9 months ago. Not barely 9 months ago. Over £100 for a pair of fucking headphones. Meant to be the studio standard, their flagship model and all this crap. They just died. It's not weird, you know, just the left one, where the thing plugs in, just suddenly died. Asked for support. No support whatsoever. Don't buy anything fucking Sony. They're shit. That includes this coming forthcoming PlayStation, because no doubt that's going to die on you just as soon as the fucking warranty goes out. And then Sony, you're going to be like, fuck you, you have to pay for more, which will probably cost more, so you might as well just buy a new console. Fuck you, Sony. You're a...
Sony, I love you. I would love a new 49 or 50-inch HD TV.
Oh my God,
so,
we are.
You know.
It's going to die after 2 weeks, and then they're going to be like, no, you have to pay to have it repaired.
And this I'm week, sorry. This rant Carry had on. Been brought to you by...
Oh, God. There it is.
By Apparently, Xbox.
Windows is... The my other PC with the bot is just being destroyed by Microsoft Edge right now. Because, you know, Windows.
And what is it with Microsoft releasing an internet browser named after a sexual practice?
You know what? I never thought of that. I'm glad you did, though, Shiver. I'm glad
you did.
What's
going to be next? Mozilla Tantric?
I mean, that's not a bad name.
I've heard worse. But it's not more like a pharmaceutical product, though. But yeah, that's a triple pack for Origin chips. And if you buy the chips from Warline, you get the helmet automatically. But if you want to use RSI credit, you have to pay more RSI credit in order to get the helmet.
I'm not... I mean... Whatever. They're going to sell stuff. Side,
13.11 is probably on 3.11.11. It's going to look really nice. It's going to play really nicely. That Origin 100 looks quite nice. I like how it's... They've done this really great job of making it look between the 85X and the 300 series.
It looks really nice. I like it. It is a gorgeous ship. And I don't say that about ships very often.
Especially yeah, Origin. I mean, you hate Origin.
Really? How do you hate Origin?
He's mad.
No, I find...
Did you notice... design-wise, that Origin 100 looks very much like a Hornet from Wing Commander.
I didn't notice, actually. I find that Origin's designs work well on small ships, but the designs, when scaled up to larger ships, falter and don't look as good. They no longer look clean and sleek. They look bloated.
Nope, I'm not going to go there. I'm not going to go there.
They look like they've just had one too many something crammed into them. You know?
I like the Origin 100. I was this close to clicking checkout to in order to get one. Really? Or to get a CCU on one. But I looked at my fleet, and, you know, I've been mistaken for the past... 6 or 9 months or whatever. I thought I still had a Mustang beta, but like when the new beta format came out, I must have, I don't know when, but sometime between now and then, I must have upgraded my beta to a Vanilla Titan.
Right.
So when I'm looking at my fleet, the only Origin 100 series I would get is the 135C because it has cargo, but it. The Avenger and the 315P both have more cargo for about the same price. So I'm guess I'm going to skip the 100 series or get it in the PU at this point.
Do you think that this is the start of a new lineup of starter ships?
I mean, they wanted the Alliant to be one of the new starter ships too. So, I mean, I think they've been trying to do a new lineup for starter ships, but they've kind of fizzled each time. I think with this one, it may catch, though.
Well, I don't know if they're going to do a new lineup of starter ships. They're starting to have a fair number of them, though I do feel like they probably want to have a starter ship from every manufacturer. Right? Or starter-ish. Like, I mean, the Avenger is close enough to a starter. The Gladius is close enough to a starter, right?
I mean, it's almost the 135C. No. Yeah, the 135C is about the same price as the 300 series. So, I mean, it's barely... In my opinion, someone should get the 300 series instead of the 100 series. But in the PU, if you're paying UEC credit for ship, go ahead and get the 100 series for something cheap and fast.
Yeah.
And that Gladius is a starter. That Gladius has a lot going for it.
It does, but it's also really like it's cheap relative to its power, right?
That punches about with rate class.
Oh, I don't know. I mean, it carries a lot of missiles.
I don't know. Maybe I don't remember how much the Gladius costs.
The Gladius is 90, unless they went up.
I think it's gone up a little bit.
Oh, if it's gone up, then.
I mean, it's a starter ship, and I think that that's how you start in Squadron.
Yeah. It's a starter. Like, it's. Oh, carbide. Anyway, the 100 is a nice, it's good looking. So this is the video. Is this the one? Yes, this is what we got as sort of a Squadron 42 tease. Now this is pretty. And I don't know what that is. That ship right there.
Isn't that the Terrapin, maybe?
I don't think it was the Terrapin.
I don't know it. Sorry, I don't know it.
Well, that's the thing. I don't. Or no, maybe it's a no. It can't be the Terrapin. Anyway, there's a question of what that ship was, because it might have been a ship that we haven't seen yet. Anyway, this is Squadron 42, and I don't know how excited I am for the Persistent Universe anymore. Like, I don't know what I'll do. It's just huge, and like it's almost oppressingly huge to me now that I have children. But Squadron 42, that I think I'll get into, because this looks really good.
I still have a couple, or at least one Squadron 42 in my package that I bought from early before they split the packages, so I'm still good. As long as I don't melt that package by accident, I'm good. Yeah, by the way, how many packages do you all have?
I think I've got two.
And they both have Squadron 42 or just one?
I don't know. I'd have to check.
You said
there. I don't think that's
I have three, maybe four.
I don't believe that's a
Squadron 42.
I have too many ships and. Don't tell my wife how much money I've spent on this game.
The question is, Shiver, are you still spending money?
No, I've spent all my money on the PC this year.
Yeah.
And your chair, without last year.
New chip.
We do also see there the mini spider, the drone, which we haven't seen in a long time, which seeing that was nice.
The people are saying that's a new ship, so you're probably right.
Yeah, I think it is. Okay, game
could be a drone. Don't forget.
Star Citizen.
We've got no idea of the scale of it.
Star Citizen. Mm. I have three game packages with Star Citizen.
And Squadron 42.
No, two of them only have Star Citizen. One of them has Squadron.
So don't melt that one.
With Squadron.
I'm not. There's no way I'm melting my Freelancer. That ain't happening. I don't know. What do you guys think of the video? Does this?
I thought I saw all the new videos. I think, but I must have missed this one somehow.
This is. So I think this was at the very beginning of the Chris Roberts video.
I'm not sure how I missed it, but okay. Oh, I was getting ready for this show. That's probably how I missed it. No, but it's cool. I'm looking at go ahead.
No, Fastcart, you go.
No, I didn't have anything. Go ahead.
I'm looking at it, and I'm thinking, you know, this looks nice. And, you know, it's one of those ones when they show off a new game, and you think to yourself, oh, this is a pre-rendered cutscene, or they've obviously souped up the graphics just to show it off. But when it is Squadron, you know that this is at least what it's going to look like. And I love the crisp textures. I love how clean they look. I love the fact that they've spent all this time on the lighting effects. And I know people are like, ray tracing, but this doesn't need ray tracing.
Because Hades is a good game. So I was playing Hades, my lovely person here has come down and handed me my Switch because she wants to make sure that I'm finished my Hades run so that she can go into my Animal Crossing and continue stealing things off my island because I no longer play Animal Crossing. So she's stealing everything on my island. So...
And that's what love is.
That is what love is, yes.
But if they've got to this point where they're now doing, I think they're doing these Squadron things monthly, they said. Is that right?
Was it monthly?
No, I think it's every 2 months.
I think they're doing this monthly.
I would love it if they do it monthly. I think it was supposed to be quarterly, though.
Yeah, I think it was
quarterly. It is quarterly.
Yeah.
So do you think that means they're at this stage now where it's going to be a year of this and then 2 years' time, at around about this time in 2 years' time, they'll be like, okay, so beta.
Well,
or do you think we're closer now, further away than that?
I think so, because they did actually say no beta this year, right? They finally came out and said it, no beta this year, which, thank you for finally saying that in October. And they said sort of a, Brian Chambers did sort of a, we're going to look at it and the second we think that it's ready for beta, we are going to let you know. The second we can pick a date and be comfortable with that date and know that that date isn't going to shift anymore, then we will tell you the date and not before then. So
Which was pretty much always the deal for, you know, everyone who's been involved following the project is like, well, that's obviously how it's going to be. Anyone who was actually expecting the beta this year was either a fool or optimistic, and there's not much
Just not listening to us, because we've been saying for 6 months that there ain't no beta this year.
I was only optimistic, but I was going to say December 31st, 11:59 p.m.
Really? What year?
Exactly.
But so one of the things that they were saying that I like when they were talking about this in the Chris Roberts video was sort of for Squadron or for the Persistent Universe, they are comfortable with showing in progress stuff. Like this is how we're reaching for this. This is our look dev for cargo holds. This is how cargo holds are progressing. This is how we've gotten to it. But they were saying that for Squadron, they don't want to do that. They want to show us stuff when it's done. Right? But that also means if they're ready to show us something new every 3 months, then hopefully that means that they're getting to the point where stuff is done. Right? I mean, this month, the break room or whatever it is that it's called, focused on Asiedo Station. Which, okay, it's a station, right? And they're saying it's something you visit really early in the game. It's, you know, one of the smallest places you visit in the game. It's one of the smallest locations, but it's the first sort of let's let players loose, and it's sort of a bit more sandbox and a bit more freeform. They can go and explore this station. And guys, I don't know about you, but I was watching that video and I think there's something bad on that station because there's a lot of dead people and it looks like there's a lot of bad guys. So spoilers, you're gonna have to fight.
You're supposed to say spoilers
station.
before you start spoiling.
The worst bit about that is all that crew were 2 days away from retirement.
Every single one. Yep.
This is a side note, but I think there's going to be plenty of people who don't like this stuff because they want to go into Squadron 42 fresh. And, you know, for people who are like that, I'm like, good luck. You're going to have 2 years trying to avoid all this stuff on Reddit, social media, videos like these. So I wish you guys luck, but hey.
But at the same time, I mean, you're right, Fastcart. And those people literally can just completely ignore everything and go do something else. But CIG do need to be showing something. They do need to show something for people like us who have got nothing better to do in our lives than just go, so, where's my game?
Yep.
It's coming. It's very slow, well, but it's coming.
Oh, I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying it's not coming, because it's going to come. But we've all been saying, okay, at least here at Relay, we've all been saying your communication is fucking appalling.
Yeah.
And this is an attempt to rectify that.
Yep. And it's and a good attempt. Well, it's a good attempt. Okay. So it's an hour and 15 minutes of look dev and like looking at one space station. Now, for a space station that we're liable to spend maybe 15 to 20 minutes of gameplay time in, I don't think they needed to spend an hour and 20 minutes looking at it. What I'm trying to say is they could have halved the length of that show. It's too long.
Well, the thing is, they don't if they do, don't if you don't. If you only make it 15 minutes, people are going to complain that it, why not make it an hour long? We want more. You built up this hype for the roadmap to the roadmap to the roadmap, and this is all we're getting, so they can't win.
It could also be the fact of, you know, well, look, we have got so much stuff we can show you. We can spend an hour talking about how much we have. Rather than, you know, it would be a lot more concerning to some people if they just did a 10-minute show and said, right, so here's this station, and it's good. We've spent some time on it. Cool. Don't get to buy our game. Bye.
No, it's more that, like, I watched... I think I got through half an hour sitting and watching it, and they sort of started to repeat themselves about areas. Like, they were talking about how they do an area... And then they talked about how they'd do the next area, but it's the same way that they did the previous area, right? Like it sort of started getting a bit repetitious, and I liked it. I liked seeing it, but there was a bit of repetition. There was actually some cooler stuff at the very end, but I was finding it hard to get through 45 minutes of, okay, I get it. It's a station. You know, it's a space station. I get it.
I mean, there are people who like you who you know, may not be into it as much.
No, but
there are other people who will be like, oh, I love this stuff. Give me more.
There are, but, and here's the problem. Tofu mentions it because I actually had forgotten. So they've got 45 minutes of here's a space station. And then after that, they switch over and they start showing off the interrupt tech. Of like that they've been talking about for conversations where you're talking to someone and then if you step away, they stop their conversation and they're like, everything okay? And then you step back towards them and they're like, right, as I was saying, and they continue their conversation. And that was a cool bit, but it was buried 45 minutes into, okay, that's a station, you know? Like, it should have been, honestly, it should have been split into two videos.
Again, people will complain too long or too short. They can't really run. But go ahead, Shiver.
Tell me about it. But, I mean, don't forget as well, it's their first one as well.
Yes.
So, but also, this is not their first rodeo either at this point.
No. They've been doing this for 7 years. Like... I would like to see the stats of how many people make it all the way through an hour and 20 minute long video, right?
I was going to, but I didn't have enough time before this started.
Anyway.
I have to, because now we're doing this.
Yeah. Anyway, I like that they did it. I'm really glad they did it. I thought the conversation stuff was super interesting. It actually looked really, really good. Like it was, oh God, sorry, itchy eye. Like it looked and seemed like it flowed. It was like the NPC was in the middle of telling a story, and then the player character stepped away, and the NPC was like, "Oh, everything okay?" and stopped and turned back to whatever he was doing. And then the character stepped back into his field of view, and the NPC turned back around and was like, right, as I was saying, let me continue my story, and continued the story right from where he left off. It was a really clean break, and that was really cool. And it's not something you see all the time in NPCs in video games, so I liked that, right?
You can tell that was done by an American studio as well. So if it was done by a British studio... Because if it was done by the British studio, when you walk off, they'd be like, you fucking rude asshole. And then when you come back, you'd be like, right, listen here, you little shit.
You know what really, really bothers me about films, movies, American TV, all of it? Hey, Shiver, we've been having a really nice conversation. Yeah, okay. Hang up. No one says goodbye. When you hang
up,
I know, but when you say goodbye when you're hanging up a phone, you don't just hang up. It bothers so much.
I don't say goodbye.
You just say hello.
You don't blame him.
Yeah.
I say hello and goodbye. So I have manners.
I don't get it. I hate it when it's like you're on the phone and then they're like, all right, bye. All right. So.
See, Shiver, in order to get around that, you have to say goodbye first, then you're off the hook.
No, I put it on the hook.
You don't have hooks anymore. Who put the phone on the hook anymore?
Everyone but Americans.
Most of the world still has phones with hooks.
The thing that I don't get in films is, why does everyone have that really fucking loud mouse? Why do hackers hack with a mouse? There's all sorts of things wrong with a movie if you want to get into technicalities, Eris.
Yeah, except for Hot Fuzz. Hot Fuzz is the only perfect movie.
Transformers movie, World's End. I actually prefer World's End over Hot Fuzz, but Hot Fuzz is pretty cool.
Hot Fuzz is the best movie ever made.
Transformers movie.
Hot Fuzz. Hot Fuzz is...
Michael...
Hot Fuzz is also the best of every single genre of movie. It's the best horror movie. It's the best car chase movie. It's the best action movie. It's even the best romance movie. The romance between Nick Frost and Simon Pegg is beautiful. It's the best horticultural movie.
How about
Earth
musical?
Earth and Shiver, I'm happy for you and I'm gonna let you finish, but Bayformers are the best movies of all time. Of all time.
Can we ban him?
Yes, we can. Yep, do it.
Let's get back on track, shall we?
Well, I think we're supposed to get to questions, if anyone's asked any. P.S., you guys should ask some questions.
I have questions.
You're on the show.
I can still ask questions. I'm a special guest. I'm even wearing a relay shirt.
It's true. You can ask questions. My apologies. Okay.
Can I just say, I love how fast Cat was like, I can ask questions, motherfucker.
I was more polite than that. No, are either of you getting a 102 ship?
Nope.
I'm happy with 325A.
I will not be buying any more Star Citizen ships, period.
I mean, you don't even have to buy. You could just CCU with credit.
I don't have anything I feel like I could get rid of. Like, I hate that it doesn't just show me all of my ships.
You can. Oh, you have the. You don't have the extension, the Chrome extension for the hangar, Hangar Explorer.
No, I don't. I don't run any Chrome extensions.
Well, there's a hangar. There's a Hangar Explorer extension to make it easy for you to shift to that. But I just went through my spreadsheet, and I found out that I didn't have a Mustang Beta anymore that I thought I had. But yeah, I turned into a Titan. So I still have 14 ships, and I have like 4 speeders, and I'm looking to get rid of one or two of them if I can, because I can't, you know, don't really have a need for all those speeders.
Yeah.
And I have 4 packages. Big package. No, I'm kidding. I have 4 packages, and I think all but one of them have Squadron 42.
Okay, I've got a Star Runner.
I have another question. Where's Theatres of War? What's going on with Theatres of War?
Oh, don't even. Don't even. It's the only thing I'm excited about playing for the next,
that's fair.
I mean, year or two. I want that's Theatres fair. Of War.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We need to go get it.
Honestly,
last year.
I'm wondering if they'll. You know what? Okay. No. It's very, very clear when we're going to get it. The week before Christmas. CIG are going to push it live. Shiver, don't even look at me like that, because you know that they do it every year. They push a major patch live just before the Christmas holidays, and someone has to come in and spend all Christmas trying to fix it, because they do it every single year. Don't even look at me like that.
I'm gonna see your bet. I'm gonna see your bet and raid you December 31st, 11:59 p.m.
No, I think it's gonna be.
They're gonna work all through New Year's holiday.
I think they're gonna try and get it out before that like Christmas New Year's break. They're gonna try and get it for like December 15th, and it's gonna break and.
Nothing they put out ever breaks. What are you talking about? Go ahead, Shiver.
I can't help but wonder if they're going to be waiting for iCache and more of the server stuff to come online with that, you know, along with like Pyro and things, just because of the smoother transitions, because it has the battlefields change, like Battlefield Rush, the more of the map opens up as you go forward, and that might be an interesting or perhaps a better way for them to test out the server meshing and things like that. I thought it's got nothing to do with making another server just to open up the map, as we already know, but
they've already had some playtests
going on.
They've already had some playtests without it though, so
true.
Maybe the playtests didn't go as smoothly as they would have liked.
I mean, when you have someone who can knock out a player with a fire extinguisher.
I just want my Nova Tonk.
Yeah. Okay, one second. I'm quickly trying to go through what is in this. There it is. Okay. Oh man. Sorry. I've got the aggressor pack, but that doesn't show up in any of the like. If you want to look at a ship, it doesn't show up. If you want to look at game packages, it doesn't show up. The only way to see the aggressor pack is if you're looking at everything. And it's really annoying. But it also came with the tray. And okay, there we go.
Yeah, can we talk about the Tonk for a bit? Because I want the Tonk.
Sure.
Because not only is it the Tonk, right? It's not just, I mean, starters, it's a fucking tank. Who doesn't love tanks? But the second, it's a massive tank that you can walk around with.
How massive is it, Shiver?
Can't say that one on Twitch. But it was very personal to you, Pascal. But yeah, I mean, that's, I don't know, I you know how I am. I'm a size queen when it comes to these things. If I can walk around a tank, that's fucking awesome. I want a tank that's imposing.
You're a size queen with everything,
massive.
I was gonna say, you heard it here first.
That's why we didn't get on well that night. But yeah, like a tank that you can walk around in that's massive. Can you just imagine that you're hunkered down, taking cover?
What are you pointing to, Shiver?
As a temporary latrine, my thighs. And then all of a sudden, this fucking huge roller tank just goes on, and you're like, oh, I'm so fucked. And that's the last thing you see before you respawn in the hospital, and you're like, yeah.
All right. We've got a couple questions. Before we get to questions, I have it. I've got my list of everything I own. I found it. Star Runner, 315P, Saber Raven, Tumbril, Avenger Stalker, Orion, Cutlass Black, Dragonfly, Banu Merchantman, Nox, Reclaimer, Endeavor Hope, Reliant Mako, Gladiator, and Freelancer. I don't need anything else. I kind of wish I could get rid of some of that.
In a moment, I'll tell you mine. I'm gonna show you mine, but that didn't come across
correctly. No, you can do that too.
I have the Constellation Taurus physical box, physical package. That's one of the first thing I got. That was back in 2014, October 20th. I have the Endeavor. And I have the Super Collider Pod and the Landing Bay for the Endeavor. I have the Constellation Aquila, the Super Hornet, the Freelancer MIS, the Prospector, Bandit Defender, the Whole B, the Avenger of Titan, the 315P Custom, there was all the new stuff they added. Not all of them, but some of them. Have a Yellow Jacket, a Ranger CV, Ranger RC, because I bought the 3-pack. And I have the Nox Courier, the silver one. That has 14 ships, plus the Endeavor stuff.
Dan Gronland, I've given away quite a bit, but total spent is 4,500 USD.
Mine is 2,500 and some cents. But some of that is from CitizenCon. You had to buy tickets and goodie package and t-shirts. Yeah.
Shiver, how much have you spent?
That. More than that added together.
You gotta stop, man. You gotta stop.
Can you type it in Twitch chat? Type it in Twitch chat. That way you won't see it.
No. I can't remember anywhere out there.
Look, almost all of those were bought before I was a married man with children. So, you know.
And the last thing I bought was...
When did you get married?
Not yet, but I mean... Well, technically common law, so 4 years ago.
The last thing I bought was the Tumbles 3-pack, and that was May of 2019.
Okay.
Thank you, Bryce Serena, for making me feel better about myself.
Yep. We got some questions. We only got four questions, but we're gonna answer them anyway. So we're gonna start with a question from Dan Gronland. What did you think of what CR said in the AMA about the changes in the Pioneer and base building?
Let me bring that up.
Yeah, basically, it was on the Ask Me Anything that Chris did on the Spectrum forums. And it was, to summarize it was, you remember how Star Wars Galaxies was like, here's a planet, go build it. It's that.
Yeah.
Basically. That's really cool. Yeah. I love that.
I loved Star Wars Galaxies before they, you know, destroyed it. Super 5 in chat says, what's the speculation in what type of ship the new one we saw in today's video is? A tow truck, some kind of new scanner ship? It's got some weird stuff on top of the ship as well. My initial speculation is it kind of has to have a military application because it's in Squadron and it's a focus of Squadron. So, I don't know. I feel like it's some sort of search and rescue or scanning or something. Because I don't think the military, the UEE, would employ a Cutlass Blue as a search and rescue vehicle.
I agree.
Right? So I'm wondering if we might get some more medical, and Endeavor is way too big. I don't believe we've got a medium or even smaller medical ship. So I'm wondering if we might see something more medical based, and something like that being a, it looked like it was flying through of a, like a destroyed, something destroyed, right? So I'm wondering if it might be sort of search and rescue medical.
So I have a follow-up to that. What manufacturer do you think it is? Because it looked Anvil-ish or Aegis to me. It looked Anvil-ish to me.
It looked Anvil or Aegis. It looked very similar to a Terrapin, to be honest, but...
Yeah, that's what I thought it was, a Terrapin.
Yeah.
I'm going with a probe. I'm also in there. I think it was a probe as well.
Oh, you're talking about a ship.
A little from column A, a little from column B. But that's what I think. I think it's a probe.
Fair enough.
It's kind of big for a probe.
You don't know
it's
how
a,
big
it's
my
a class
are.
9 probe. Dan Gronlund also asks, what are your thoughts on the different IA blades that was listed in the AMA?
Yeah, that's another really a lot of these things. It's server racks for the AI assisted computer. I think that's how you say it. Things like targeting assist, electronic warfare assist, or offense or defense, things like that. Really cool ideas that have been spoken about before, but in a bit more detail, let us hope it comes to fruition.
Funnily enough, we've known what... sorry, Super. Nightbot is... yeah, do that. What is it?
Oh, that's spoilers. Well, not spoilers, but here we are.
Yeah, that picture does put things in a new perspective. So I don't think it's a probe anymore.
That, it had that thing on top. That's why I thought it was a Terrapin.
Yeah, it looks... I mean, it looks almost, what, hammerheady? Like, I don't know. It. I'm interested
it
to see
what
it's going to be.
It could be a Terrapin. Or a Valapin.
Yeah. Funnily enough, that you're mentioning the blades in the IA blades in the ships. We've actually known that they were going to have that stuff since
ages ago.
2014. I remember doing a whole bunch of Excel work actually. Comparing all of the weapon damages to figure out which weapons were best, because we could get all of that from the crap. I don't remember the extension of the files. Anyway, there were every ship had its own CSV. I don't remember what the extension was.
JSON file?
No, it was something else.
The JSONs?
No, there was something else. But they were easily like. Readable, but they had, even back then, they had slots for ships' computers, targeting ships. Like, they had all these slots already ready.
Did they have a mail slot, right, Shiver?
You know what? Bryce Arena, you're kind of right. I really liked doing that Excel work.
Have you played Eve?
I tried and died instantly. Too much.
Then you're doing it wrong.
Too much.
Eve Online is Excel PvP.
I don't like PvP. I don't
like Eve.
I don't play PvP. I don't enjoy it.
I was a caber on Eve.
But yeah, I'm no, you know what? Super 5 is right. Like, this is how I like my ship reveal. It's like, ooh. What is that? We can speculate, and we can wonder, and we can be like, what are we getting? right? And we can start talking again about, like, well, what are we missing? Because I really think that we are missing two things in Star Citizen, one of which is a medium medical ship, because no one likes the Cutlass, and two is a food truck. And you know what? Both of those things are incredibly necessary in a military context, because one...
Food truck?
No, listen to me. I'm going to explain. One, soldiers need to be healed if they're hurt. But you know what? If you're doing a war right, your soldiers aren't getting hurt. So a medical truck is not nearly as necessary as a food truck, because guess what? Whether soldiers are sick or fine, they need to eat 3 to 4 times a day. You need to supply them food. And when they're on the front lines and they don't have access to the cafeteria on an Idris, you need to have a vehicle that can take them food, hot, warm food. I think it's guaranteed a food truck.
Eris hasn't ever heard of the mess then.
What am I?
Isn't that where they scan your brain?
Yes. They as far as the blade goes, for me, missile defense system, that's cool. The E-War stuff is cool. They have a mining blade? Interesting. Salvaging? I'll probably do salvaging on my manual. Shield management, that would be something that I'm very much interested in. And probably drone management for me, if I have a ship that has drones. But it's, the shield management is for me.
I also like that it's you're going to be able to swap it out, and you'll be able to spend credits on, like, smarter blades that can more.
They're gonna have tiers.
Yeah. And that's good. It's more to evolve your AI capabilities.
Here's a question. Do you think you'll ever get a blade that will be as good as a player?
No. Nope.
Depends on how bad the player is.
I mean, you'll
if
easily
it's landing,
be able to...
yeah.
You'll easily be able to get a blade that's better than me.
Yeah, you could get a blade that's better than me. It doesn't talk as much.
Well, what's the fun in that?
Dive turkey? I can get my own voice back.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I seem to have set the blade to street.
Spaceship Training Wheels has a question. Will we see Pyro by the end of the year? I mean, you can always go see it by just looking at last year's videos.
Or looking in the, not the Galactopedia, the, Arc Star map.
Yep. No, I don't think we will. Not in-game at any rate.
I believe that Chris said that that's coming with, with the iCache and shit.
Yeah, I don't think we're gonna get an expansion. They can't expand the verse any more than they have right now until they get server shit figured out.
Well, like,
they probably could, but it's not worth it. It's not worth it.
I was gonna say they probably could. They can do anything if they really wanted to. But...
they could do it the old-fashioned way.
Yeah,
but then that's one of these major problems is. They could just ram in a lot of shit right now and do it old-fashioned way, cut corners, etc., etc. There are ways that they could do it. There are ways they can trick the system into making you do that. But then the problem is, when it comes round to actually implementing the stuff, they would have already done X amount of work, take all that work, and then just throw it away.
Let's
that
be honest.
Is literally wasting their time,
and they have literally learned from that because they've already done that when they had what's their faces do the Star Marine irrelevant games fuck, what were they called?
They did Friday the 13th. Why can I remember their games but not their bloody name?
I know.
I have no idea what they're talking about. Sorry, folks.
The people outsourced the FPS stuff to X company that we can't remember.
Ilphonic.
Thank you, Bluesy.
Ilphonic. Yeah, well, but that's what they
and
did,
by the
right?
Time
they tried
that done that.
They tried to outsource
bring it, back
it
in because
they tried to get it done the quick and easy way, which was outsource it, let someone else do it, and we'll focus on everything else. And then it came back and didn't work, right? So I think that sort of cemented in probably Chris's mind, really, that they're not going outside for anything. They're not going to do things the quick and easy way.
They can still outsource some things that can still be imported, like turbulent texture work.
Turbulent
is
still outsourced.
Web stuff. Yeah, exactly. Web stuff.
But not like they wanted to outsource the FPS stuff because they figured it would be easier to outsource than to do it themselves.
Yeah, then they added new studios like Derby.
Yeah. And I think that's what they decided to
Derby.
Do. So Derby.
It's not a fucking horse race.
They've got 50 people working at Turbulent now, apparently. Which is great. Anyway, next question here is from Folostan. How much time will you spend trolling NPCs in Squadron 42 to get all of the wild lines? I'll probably try it once and then accidentally do it 3 or 4 times, but it's literally not something I'm going to spend my time doing. When someone is talking to me, whether it's in a video game or in real life, I stand and pay attention to what they're saying.
Eris, at least you can stand. Anniversary show, folks! All the classic line come back. No, but what was the question? It slipped my mind. I'm trying to be funny.
What? Right. Sorry.
How much time are you going to spend trolling NPCs by midway conversation just walking away?
I was going to. I'll probably do my first run through. Not run through, but you know, playing a game, walk through. Not even that. Cut through. Playing a game. You know. Just trying to get the best outcome possible. Then on sequential playthroughs, I'll go through and see all the goofy stuff.
See, Fastcart, you missed an opportunity to say you're going to spend 3/5 of your time trolling people.
He did it, folks. He did it. I didn't. I was trying to be good. So how did it feel under the bus, Shiver? How did it feel? The bus felt good on top of you?
You were really trying to get me to say no.
Tofu asks, is there more Star Citizen info coming up this week? I think next
week... The weekly thing on
Monday.
We'll
have the weekly Inside Star Citizen again, which is good. Who knows what else? I don't remember. Did they? I don't. Did they say anything else? Like, the roadmap is still coming. They showed a bit of Squadron. Is that all they're doing for? Like, is this all they're doing for?
Is that all they're doing? Haven't they done enough? You want more?
No, they haven't. Yeah. Where are my panels? I want Tony Zurovec strapped into a chair and talking for 2 hours. That's it.
Why did you have to be strapped to a chair?
That's his fetish.
Ah.
You know, because reasons. No, is this all we're getting for CitizenCon this year? Are they going to?
Didn't they say it was going to be an in-game event?
I thought so.
That's the stuff. That's the stuff that I posted, the goodies stuff and the helmet stuff. That's in-game.
Yeah, but
that's it.
But like this doesn't seem like much, honestly. When a normal CitizenCon has, you know, what? Eight 1 hour long
presentations,
deep dives, and then there's always a like half hour to an hour long thing with Chris at the end where they show what's coming up.
We also have to remember the anniversary sale coming out, so expect more of that. Like, this is the Squadron 42 stuff, and then the anniversary stuff is going to be Star Citizen stuff.
I don't know. It feels wrong if we don't get that. We don't know.
I mean, maybe we are a bit... Maybe we sound a bit entitled, but...
It's what we've had for 7 years. It's not like we've
given money into the project or anything.
Yeah, but this is a special year. They couldn't do all the things that, you know... They probably have some things in mind that they're probably saving for Citizen Con when we can actually get together again.
But then we're going to miss on, like... They had to have had in their minds already what they were going to do for panels, right? Because they have to plan that stuff months in advance. So when they decided to cancel it, they probably already knew lots of what they were going to do and what they were going to hopefully show. Last year, we got a jump point, right? And a brief intro to, like,
This is what I mean. They got people in Reddit and other places saying, this is too much stuff. This data dump is too much. And then you have people here on Relay saying, oh, we want more. This isn't enough. Give us more. I'm saying, wait a month. See what happened then. And then complain if it's not still not enough for you.
No. I have to say I disagree because... Well, no. No. We normally have a day, and that's CitizenCon, that we know we're going to get X info.
Well, they gave us 2 days. They gave us October 8th with the 3.1 stuff and the 100 stuff and other stuff, the letter from the chairman and everything. Then we have today with the two videos. One is an hour and 14 freaking minutes long, and the other one is 15. They gave us 90 minutes of content stuff. So...
But is there more?
It's not 8 hours, but it's, you know, 90 minutes.
I don't know. It seems like they could have done more for CitizenCon, and I hope that this isn't it.
I want all the staff wheeled out onto the stage. I want to see their tissue walrus impressions because they've all got corona. I want to see them wearing masks and saying, yeah, so this year we all got really fucking ill.
Just no. I want more than 15 minutes of Chris talking. Like all we got is 15 minutes of Chris saying we got the
letter from the chairman too. We got more than 15 minutes. We got the letter from the chairman.
Well, we get a letter from the chairman every year at CitizenCon, and then he has an intro where he most years when okay. they're like when they're like we when they're like we screwed up and you're not seeing anything. But, like, there's normally more. Do you know what I mean? Like,
I know what you mean, but, you know.
I mean, fair enough, yeah. There's usually a look back on what they've achieved this year.
Yeah, that I am missing.
There's not much this year. They can just say, so, did a couple of patches.
Well, they don't,
It's the what's coming bit. That, yeah, exactly. But... That might well be coming for if there's going to be a Christmas stream this year, that might be what they do because they've got to hold something back because this year has been more limited than ever before in what they can achieve and what they have achieved. So maybe they've got to hold something back for Christmas because otherwise they're just going to sit there, throw another monitor off the table, and then everyone's going to complain about that.
That's fair, but tell me.
Why?
That's
going to come across as prick teasing, though. They're going to be like, "Oh, we're going to show you this, but you wait until Christmas. We're going
to
show
you." To Silver's point, they were complaining about people. People were complaining about having a roadmap to the roadmap. If they put that out saying that we're going to do this again, people complain about that again.
Actually, he's hit on something there, following up from that, because it's not just going to be, you know, that looks like they're trying to get this roadmap out for around about the Christmas time, and it's not just going to be Chris wheels out onto the stage, Hannibal Lecter style, and says, they're going to be like, here's the roadmap. And...
You're both forgetting something. The reason we got that roadmap to the roadmap was because when they first told us about the roadmap, they were like, yeah, it's coming soon. In a couple weeks. Remember? And then after a couple weeks, when we were all like, hey guys, where's the roadmap? Then they were like, that just okay, fine.
That just means they learned their lesson. Because, you know, they don't want to promise something and then have to push back or not deliver because something came up again.
Then here's what we're doing now. This is what we're doing now. We're going to focus on the community, and but don't worry, you can still expect to hear some more about where we're going later this year. Stay tuned. Like, it doesn't have to be much. But it just doesn't feel like this is a celebration. This is a celebration for people that play the game.
I think Eric is just missing the community and not going out and being in LA. I think he's. I mean, I'm not trying to speak for you, but I think maybe you're frustrated about not being able to go and actually be there and seeing everything and everything.
I just want my panels, man.
Yeah, that would be something that we would have had a pandemic not happen.
Yeah. If they had panels this year from the privilege of their own home done over Zoom with the Chinese spying, it would have been things like, so this year's been a bit shit.
No, yeah, but
10 minutes
but look,
later, that's the end of our presentation. Thank you for coming.
No, you're thinking so small. Look at last year. You know what we got last year? And we watched this...
Last year when there wasn't a pandemic, yeah.
No, but hold on. Yeah. Last year when there wasn't a pandemic, we got a presentation by Tony Z on the Quanta.
Quanta.
Right? Now,
weren't you on a podcast talking about that recently?
I was. I was on Soul Citizens talking about that. But that entire presentation was literally just Tony Z talking about slides, right? It's one person talking about the state of one of the biggest things in Star Citizen. Why don't we get an update on Quanta or an update on server meshing or an update? There's stuff that they...
Actually, we got some stuff in the AMA, didn't we? Mm-hmm. Or whatever. Yeah.
Exactly. I mean, sure, it was a panel, but it's right there.
I mean, it's a data dump. Oh. It's just not a person presenting it to you.
I literally didn't even know there was an AMA.
You want the link again? I'll give you the link. Give me a moment.
I knew this. Why didn't you know this?
I don't go on Reddit.
It's not on Reddit, it's on the comlink.
I tried to avoid Reddit myself as well.
It's on the comlink.
Yeah.
Let me link the comlink.
Okay, I don't go on RSI's webpage.
This is why I watch Salt Citizens. Fair. They've got their fingers on the pulse. They know what's going on.
Spectrum, man? Fuck Spectrum.
And that's another reason I watch Station. That's another reason I watch Soul Citizens is because they're still optimistic and hopeful.
Yeah, they haven't been doing this
Love
for
you,
8 years.
And Griffin.
They haven't been doing
There's
this for 8 years.
There's that other guy that's on there, that fucking fast car. He's trouble.
Yeah, he's
oh,
a
shit,
jerk.
He's here.
Did Dad know?
I don't know. I hope that we get something more.
I think
we might.
I think we're getting more in November and like Shiver said in December. So we have 2 more months.
Maybe they haven't quite finished giving us some more shit from this, and they're going to be like at the end of it, okay, and that's all we've got. Stay tuned for Christmas. I mean, it probably won't be, but you never know. And there is the whole hope for Christmas, because it's not just going to be right. Here's a roadmap. Fuck off. It's going to be, here's the roadmap, and here's what you can look forward to. Here's some of the things we achieved this year, which isn't really much, but we've got to drag this out to at least 10 minutes.
And I hope we get something. It's just, I don't know. You know when you've got like this thing that you're looking forward to as a semblance of normalcy and no, but no, really, like.
No, I know. It's hard this year to have it.
It sucks to not...
Dan Grunlin says it right. It's okay to hope, but there is a pandemic, so keep it in your pants a bit.
I know, believe me, I know there's a pandemic. But I mean,
yeah, the UK's not handling it well.
They're not. Neither is the States, let's be honest. But
neither the States.
But to be fair, there have been how many
to
major
be fair.
To be fair, there have been how many major video game events this year? I mean, Microsoft
have
done
fair,
it, Sony have
how
done
many,
it.
How many things have been delayed? Like Cyberpunk 2027 delayed twice.
It's been delayed.
Hang on, just one fucking minute here. Microsoft, a massive multi-billion dollar company. Yeah, I expect them to go out on stage and risk one of their own and sacrifice someone.
They didn't go on stage.
Sony, fuck Sony, they're assholes.
Well, yeah, we know that.
Don't buy
Microsoft,
a PlayStation.
Microsoft did it all from their own homes. They all did presentations from their own homes. Same with the Game Awards.
Have they not been doing Star Citizen content from their own homes?
Have
I been tripping out?
No, but Shiver, that's my point. They have. So there's nothing that would stop them from doing panels from their own homes. We've seen
they're
that they can.
They're totally fucking is of what, I mean, because they're working from home, they can't quite do as much as they can. So maybe every time that they've gone on Zoom and had the Chinese spy on them and steal it so they can make Stardew Citizen rule.
They've given us everything.
It would just
the Chinese
be,
have made
well,
Genshin
well, the
Impact.
Only thing
they
could do is just do
else.
A compilation. But maybe it should just, maybe all it would be is just a compilation of absolutely every single Zoom call to date. And just be like, this is it. This is literally all we've been able to do.
Maybe.
I mean, yeah, maybe. Yeah, okay. There's a good chance that it's not. But assuming the worst.
Let me give some hope here. A little bit of hope. Like, hopefully next year the States will get their act together. Hopefully. and we'll have a citizen con in LA, hopefully. And you know, we can have all this stuff that you're missing this year. But for this year, I think this is it.
That's not much hope.
And
they've been telling us
for the past few weeks and few months, like the community has been hyping, and then they sent out this weekend starts at the very last line. I said, we've been seeing content creators, you know, like having certain expectations of what's going to happen this week. They were trying to manage our expectations, and you know, some of it's listened better than others. But you know, it's like just last week I was saying, "Oh, they're gonna do this." No, I was more like you, and I was like, "Then I saw this weekend Star Citizen," and I was like, "Okay, maybe not. We'll probably get a few videos, and that's what they gave us and some more information." So,
I hear what you guys are saying. But I think I think there needed to be a middle ground, and I don't think that what we got is enough. I'm not asking for a full citizen con, but I was asking for more than what we got, and I don't think a 10-minute video with Chris is enough.
You're entitled to your opinion.
Yeah.
But if it's all they have, it's all they have.
That's fair. And if it's all they have...
Why couldn't they have CitizenCon in Japan this year? Because me and the rest of the Japanese Star Citizen community, the whole five of us, we could have done that. We could have socially distanced and it could have been completely safe in just a little back room.
Hey, they could have done it up here in Canada.
We would have been fine.
The problem with that is the Americans couldn't have come because we're on no-fly list, so we couldn't have attended.
That's why it's perfect to do a Japanese citizen.
Or Canadian. They could have done it in Canada, man. We don't have nearly as many cases. Anyway,
I would have gone to Canada. Go ahead.
I want to show something quick before we end for today. because we're just about done. This is the thing.
This show went someplace I didn't expect this show to go. What is this?
Hear me now. All crimes should be treasured if they bring thee pleasure somehow.
October 30th, Table of Horrors. It's a
Nitro made that amazing intro. Thank you, Nitro.
I want to end here, one, by thanking Fastcart for being on. Check out Soul Citizens tomorrow. What time?
8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific. We're going to go through the years of CitizenCon, of, you know, things we like and things we don't like. It should be interesting. And I would and I would encourage Eris to come to stop by, or, you know, stop by the stream and, you know, check it out. Because I'm pretty sure that Kimmy and Griffin has been watching you, and they came up with a whole bunch of content for everything you've been talking about just now.
I don't know. Griffin just set up there. I feel you, David. It's nice, but it's not been as fulfilling, which is kind of what I'm trying to say. So... the only other thing I want to say is, I have absolutely no faith, that America will pull itself out of this, shitty tailspin that it's found itself in. So for every single one of you that is an American, you better damn go and vote, and you better vote for Biden, because, hey, you're fucking the world over, and, I'm fucking fed up with it.
I was just going to say, I wasn't going to go that quite that far. I was going to say, make sure you vote, if, no matter where you are, American or, you know, anyone in the world, but make sure you vote. Also, wear a mask, if not for yourself. Wear a mask so that we could have a CitizenCon next year.
Yep. And to those of you that have gone and voted, thank you very much. Good on you. And with that... thank you all so much for coming and hanging out and watching. Shiver, sorry. Oh, you've
stop
got more stuff.
The fuck there. All right.
Don't oppress him.
Jesus Christ. Yeah.
It's time. Go, Shiver. Do
first
your stuff.
Of all, right before this podcast, over on the Astro Pub, Jenk is running a Star Wars RPG, which you should tune into because they have a lot of fun and Dolvac is amazing. Just watch it for Dolvac, if nothing else, for starters. Second of all, we're going to do Vampire the Masquerade in 2 hours. Is it fast cut?
Yeah.
2 hours. And as you can already guess, we've got fast cut guesting. So tune in for that over on Table of Horrors.
I had nothing to wear.
Even better.
And now we're good?
And Soul Citizens tomorrow. No, I'm kidding.
Oh,
go ahead.
Tuesday game show, and Saturday right back here again. Same time, same channel, same clothes, same underwear. I never change anything. So long, everyone.
You turn them inside out. You double the wear length.
If you just wear them for long enough, they sort of like shrivel up and stick to your skin, and then you just never need to change ever.
I never have anything shrivel up on me.
Bye, y'all.